Yeah.
Kuwapo, napakasela naman ng bidding process tapos kaya wala daw siya pakialam. Nag-advise lang siya pero nandun silang lahat.
If supervisor ka, you talk to those supervised.
Right, that's right.
He was talking to detectives.
That's right,
oh, medyo,
yes.
Ito lang ako medyo...
Tanungin mo.
Ito lang ako medyo may gano'n na.
Oo. Oh, oh.
Supervisor.
Again, good afternoon. This my presentation will, I think, only 12 slides, composed of 12 slides. Please, next. These are the composition of the new BAC members. We assume office, we assume the, as members, sometime mid-March. And I am the chairman, and concurrently the deputy chief for administration. The vice chairman is police director Perez, the concurrent director for logistics, police director Ramirez, the director for controllership, director Rojas, the director for research and development, and chief superintendent Uyami, the director of the legal service. During our proceedings, here are the regular members, observers, from COA, DIG representatives, NAPOLCOM representative, from the Chinese Chamber of Commerce, from the PNP Press Corps, and from the NGO. Next slide, please. These are the initiated reforms since we are new in the BAC.
Please forgive me. Can you please return to the prior slide?
Yes,
na map observer?
Yes, ma'am.
Si Mr. Puno.
Actually, ma'am, under the DIG representative. Doon po siya nakapasok.
Okay. Please proceed. Thank
you. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Here are the reforms initiated by the new BAC. Enhancement of the composition of technical working group. Usually, we only have the BAC secretariat and the TWG, but we divided the TWG into two. TWG for documents and TWG for technical specifications. In all stages, we observe transparency. Especially in the procurement
Excuse
process.
Excuse me,
yes.
Comment from the chair, maniwala naman ako. Go ahead.
Yes, ma'am, but honestly, yun po ang aming ginagawa sa BAC proceedings. And we strictly adhere to the provisions of the Republic Act 9184 and its revised IRR, pati po yung mga supplemental policies from the GPPP. Next slide. Here is the standardized bidding procedure based on the 9184 IRR, pre-proc, advertisement, pre-bid, then during the opening of the technical envelope and preliminary examination, nakasama rin po dyan yung opening of financial envelope, bid, evaluation, and ranking. Then immediately after, we proceed to the post-qualification. After the post-qualification, issuance of notice to proceed, then contract preparation and signing, approval of the contract, and then issuance of notice to proceed. Next. Now, for the procurement of pistol, 9mm pistol, we are supposed to procure 59,904 units. The unit price is established to be at 20,000 with an ABC or approved budget for the contract, as mentioned a while ago, close to 2 billion. Now, the total, at first, when we proceeded to the opening of bid, initially, the joint venture of Spinelli and IWI got the lowest calculated bidder. And now, the company was post-disqualified, and immediately we proceeded to the next lowest calculated bidder, which is the joint venture of Trust Trade and Glock. They submitted a bid of 16,659.94. For the information of the Madam Chair and Senator Pimentel, in the market, basically it's more or less 40,000 to 45,000. And if you could remember right, during the recently conducted gun show, the price is more or less 32,000 to 38,000. then the total bidded price, as far as the Glock, the trusted is concerned, is 997,997,045. And this will entail a savings for the Philippine National Police of 200,082,000. Next slide. With that savings divided by the bidded price, this will enable us to again procure, if ever we will decide later, additional 12 units of Glock 12,000 units of Glock pistol. Next. Okay. These are the timeline or histogram of procurement pertaining to this procurement, pertaining to pistol. On May 17, we conducted the pre-procurement. Then we had advertisement of ITB on May 24. We had the pre-bid on June 7. And we had the original date of submission of opening of bids on June 21. But some of the bidders requested for the extension, considering that some of their samples will still be coming from other countries. So we accepted or we granted the request, and now we scheduled the opening and submission of bids on June 28. So then on July 4, we started the post-qualification process. And just like what I mentioned, Spinelli and IWI was declared, was post-disqualified for two grounds. First, they failed to submit the required receipt of authentication in connection with the exclusive authority to sell. And second, the certificate of authority issued by the Insurance Commission that the surety company is authorized to issue surety bond callable upon demand. Okay, next. Then we started the post-qualification of trust trade going to the next bidder on July 13. Then we conducted the post-qualification until August 14, meaning they already passed the post-qualification. Then we proceeded to the notice award on August 31, then posting of performance security. The bidder, the proponent, posted their performance security on September 6, and the signing of the contract on September 10, 2012. The contract was signed by Madam Joy Gutierrez Jose of Trust Trade and the Director for Logistics, Director Perez. Now it is in the office of the Chief of the Philippine National Police, General Bartolome, for the signing of the for the approval, being the head of the procuring entity. And he is given 15 days from September 10 until September 25. Then after that, we'll be going to issue the notice to proceed. Next. As agreed upon and as a requirement, the proponent should deliver to us in 5 tranches or phases. Within 150 days, they are supposed to deliver 12,000 units. Next 120 days, 10,000 something units. Next 120 days, 12,696. Next 90 days, 12,605. Next 90 days, 12,000 something. For a total of 570 days, they should be able to deliver 59,904 units as required. Next. Okay. Basically, sir, Madam Chair, that is the stages of the pistol process, the process for the procurement of pistol. Can we proceed to the rifle?
Yes, please.
Yes, thank you, ma'am. Okay. First, there are two procurement for the rifle. Embodied in the Capability Enhancement Program for 2011, we are supposed to procure 1,500 with an ABC or approved budget for the contract, 178 million something, or a unit price of 118,888. Next. Here is the schedule, histogram of that procurement. Under Capability Enhancement Program 2011, procuring 1,500 units. On April 19, we conducted the pre-procurement conference. Then April 24, advertisement of invitation to bid. May 3, first pre-bid conference. Then we decided to conduct another conference, pre-bid conference, on May 10. On May 31, we conducted the opening and submission of bid. And here are the proponents who bought the bidding documents, who participated and participated in the procurement. Singapore Technology Kinetics Floor International, Casil Leisure Resources, Aris Pinelli Trading, PV Junicio, Armaments Unlimited, Roferma, Nasse Enterprises. And apparently, there was only one bidder who submitted the bid, in the person of R. Spinelli, joint venture with IWI. And they submitted a bid price of $89,450. Then we started the post-qualification on June 4. Next. On June 25, we received a telephone call from the SILG directing the review of the unit price of the basic assault rifle. It was received by the head of the secretariat in the person of Attorney Edwin Roque. On July 11, the technical working group submitted a report post-disqualifying J.B. Spinelli on the same grounds, as in the pistol, because they submitted the same documents. And on August 14, we issue a resolution declaring a post-disqualification of J.B. Spinelli Trading and the joint venture with IWI. Next item. Now, this is the 1,800 under the Capability Enhancement Program 2012 with an ABC of 230 million something with a unit price of 118. Next. On June 13, we conducted the pre-procurement. On June 23, we advertised the invitation to bid. And on June 25, we received a telephone call from SILG, as I mentioned a while ago. Medyo nag-overlap po ito yan eh, yung 1,500 and 1,800. Now, we started with that instruction that for us to suspend the assault rifle with the, meron po nagsasabi na medyo mataas po yung presyo. So, we immediately prepared a supplemental bid bulletin sometime 27 to 29, canceling or suspending the procurement of that 1,800. And we issued a bid bulletin finally on July 2, 2012. Okay. That's all, Madam Chair.
Thank you.
We are now ready for the question.
Can you have the lights back on, please? Dalawa itong kontratang pinag-uusapan natin. Yung isa tungkol sa assault rifles, no?